Hi, everyone. My name is Pooja Upadhyay, and I'm a PhD student at the University of Maryland.
Hello, my name is Sharon Heung, and I'm a PhD student at Cornell Tech. We'll be presenting our paper, Studying Exploration and Long-Term Use of Voice Assistance by Older Adults. This is work done with Dr. Shiri Azenkot from Cornell Tech and Dr. Robin Brewer from the University of Michigan. In today's presentation, we're going to share an interview study about how older adults in long-term care communities adopt and use Alexa for over a year. So in general, there's been an increased interest in voice assistance in older adults within human-computer interactions research. Prior work has studied voice assistance use and non-use for varying lengths of time. Most studies have focused on short-term use or new users, and these studies may be susceptible to novelty effects. For example, Pratt et al. Found their participants initially used voice assistance for music, but then their use actually diminished over time. In general, experienced users may have a different behaviors or perceptions compared to novel users. There was one study by Trashkova et al. That did do a longer deployment study, but they focused on and reported voice assistant non-use. So they found that their participants ended up abandoning voice assistants and preferred their own smartphones. Prior work has also considered different contexts of older adults, like living at home or in a long-term care facility. Much of this work has focused on older adults aging in place. There has been an increased attention on older adults in long-term care because of opportunities to understand voices and use in group settings, also with different stakeholders, including caregivers, and there's been commercial interest in deploying these voice assistants into care communities. Overall, there's this gap in understanding how older adult residents adopt and use Alexa after a long period of time.
We made a connection with SoundMind, a former startup, as part of our co-authors' previous projects. SoundMind developed customized Echo devices relevant for long-term care communities, such as a care plan skill would give information about events at the community or meals at the community. They would do music integrations and game integrations on the Alexa devices. SoundMind also provided training for residents on how to use Alexa. We had an opportunity to work with one such long-term care community where some participants, some residents participated in SoundMind's program and had used Alexa for a year. Given gaps in past work and the opportunity to work with SoundMind and the residents' community, we asked three research questions. First, how did residents learn to use voice assistants? Second, how did residents use voice assistants to support their routines? And third, what were residents' perceptions of voice assistants' conversational capacities? In this presentation, we focus on the first two research questions.
In order to address these research questions, we conducted 60-minute semi-structured interviews with 10 participants. We first started to recruit, and we partnered with a community staff member to share our recruitment flyer. Each participant used their Amazon Alexa devices for at least a year, and they were a part of SoundMind's community. We then interviewed two research team members, recorded and conducted these 45 to 90 minute phone interviews. And during the interview, we asked questions about their mental models of Alexa and their Alexa use. We ended the interview with a contextual demonstration where we did ask participants to interact with Alexa in real time. For analysis, we coded interview transcripts and iteratively developed a code book. And then we conducted digital affinity mappings to group codes in two themes.
We organize our findings into three sections. First, learning how to use Alexa. Second, incorporating Alexa into daily routines. And third, perceptions of Alexa's conversational capacities. In this presentation, we only talk about key parts of the first two, but please refer to our paper for more details. We start with talking about how participants learn to use Alexa, first via SoundMind's training. SoundMind's flyers, similar to the examples on this slide, were distributed to residents' apartments on a frequent basis. Notice how it has examples of general searches like nutrition, spellings, examples of music use like a meditation track or a Bob Marley radio, device commands such as pause, play, volume, next. Such flyers help participants gain familiarity with the system in early days of use, after which, as participant P4 says, you just get used to the system. Something important that we don't discuss today is that once participants were familiar, they continue to learn more about the system through their own exploration and trial and error. They apply this kind of system learning to develop creative uses over time, which we describe in this section, incorporating Alexa into daily routines. Alexa's general skills, like music and search, are often taken for granted as working well due to the design of the system. Instead, participants thought of creative and novel uses of these skills that are not accounted for in the design of the skills. Let's look at an example of the use of music skills first. P9 uses Alexa's music to enhance their recovery and well-being. She says, "I fell from a crack in the sidewalk and I needed to lie down. I would use Alexa to play music and go to sleep. The music is what hooked me. I was always a Sinatra fan." Here, P9 requests, instead of a specific music track, a Sinatra playlist. Then Alexa auto-plays music without needing her intervention, without pausing, helping her rest uninterruptedly. But here's an example of participants putting the playlist feature to use in group activities where it doesn't quite work. P3 explains that the director of a group exercise class would start out by requesting music that worked for exercise, but then Alexa would go on and autoplay the next song using its own judgment, which didn't really work well for exercise. These examples show how the design of the music skill doesn't always account for how users apply features of skills like playlists to their own context. Now let's look at participants' novel uses of Alexa's search skills. Contrary to the notion that voice assistants can replace graphical systems like computers and smartphones for searches, our participants actually only saw Alexa as best suited for retrieving general information, like what happened during World War II. Knowing this, they had diverse novel uses of general searches. Let's look at a couple examples. P4 engaged Alexa's general skills to enhance his daily cognitive stimulation routine. He typically spends his morning solving the daily newspaper's crossword, and now Alexa acts as a quick resource for word spellings and meanings. Similarly, another participant, P10, uses Alexa to continue learning about new topics whenever he desires, like in between watching something on TV, he would want to know about a fact. In this way, he describes Alexa's general and quick search skills as making it an encyclopedia for facts. These examples show how participants derive creative uses by understanding the system's capacities and then putting its specific features like playlists or general searches to creative uses like enhancing their routines.
From these findings, we present design recommendations related to designing voice assistants for sustained use and as conversational partners. We're only going to highlight a couple of recommendations that relate to sustained use, so be sure to read our paper to see all of our design recommendations. So for our participants, SoundMind's mixed modality training program was a contributing factor to their sustained use. SoundMind provided these curated and regularly updated flyers for older adults, and that supported their continuous learning and command discovery over a long period of time. And so we recommend voice assistant learning and exploration should be off the device, like flyers and in-person demonstrations, and with the device, like how-to commands or ways to ask the device on how to explore capabilities and structure certain commands. Our next design recommendations relate less about training and more about designing for meaningful voice assistant use for older adults in long-term care. First, we recommend designing multi-step skill scaffolding. Participants found value in using the care plan application, which helped them remind them of community events, but they didn't know how and wanted a way to know how to set up and modify the frequency and delete certain reminders. We recommend that designers incorporate custom skill scaffolding to support these multi-step commands and applications relevant to older adults, including community information and health-related reminders. Participants valued music, and this was found in our findings, and music may seem like a very basic skill, but for our participants, it was used by all of our participants, and also it was supported their individual and social routines. Participants did have difficulty retrieving music that they had heard or liked previously. And so we recommend researchers and designers to look into more nuanced music-related interactions, like creating playlists, bookmarking desired content, and retrieving saved content or being a way to see your previously played history. Our final recommendation relates to our participants living in a long-term care facility. Alexa supported their group activities like being the DJ during yoga or facilitating trivia night by asking Alexa fun facts. We recommend future work to explore these kinds of voice assistant group use in community living and how to resolve conflicts, especially in group settings. We would like to thank our participants, staff at the residence community, and SoundMind for making this study possible. We contribute an underrepresented perspective of older adults being these experienced users and adopting Alexa in really creative ways to support the community living, well-being, and information needs. Be sure to read our paper. Thank you for listening, and feel free to reach out if you have any questions.